Does vapor smoothing increase the strength of your 3D prints? I've smoothed the ABS parts with acetone and polysmooth with isopropyl alcohol and tested their strength against their untreated counterparts. Let's find out more. Guten Tag everybody, I'm Stefan and welcome to CNC Kitchen. So I've just reached 100,000 subscribers here on YouTube, which is an amazing milestone for me. It is unbelievable to see how many other people are interested in the geeky things I earlier actually only did for myself. If you also have ideas and projects that you want to share, for example here on YouTube, and maybe even grow a business out of it, then Skillshare, who's today's sponsor, might be the place that can teach you the necessary skills. Skillshare is an online learning community for creators with more than 25,000 classes in design, business and more. If you don't know where to start, then maybe check out Mac Ballack's video series on the 4 pillars of YouTube success, which guides you through the basic steps of starting and running a YouTube channel. Trust me, it's not going to be a piece of cake, but at least this might make the way a little easier. So with less than $10 a month for an annual subscription, Skillshare is super affordable, and using the link in the description, you'll get a 2-month free trial. Join the more than 7 million creators that are already learning with Skillshare. Sponsors like Skillshare and the support of the community, especially my awesome patrons, have allowed me to run this channel now as my part-time job. Now, back to the investigation. Vapor smoothing is a technique where you put your 3D printed parts into a solvent vapor that then dissolves and smooths the outer surfaces of the prints. Everyone who has already been working with 3D printed parts knows that their strength is usually considerably lower when they are loaded in between layers rather than in the printing plane. This is caused by the layers not perfectly melting together and also because the layers cause small stress risers where a crack will eventually form. Vapor smoothing will even out this roughness and might even cause the layers to fuse together more. This is exactly what we will try to find out today. For this, I've been printing a set of test samples, of which we'll vapor treat one half, then test their strength on my DIY universal test machine and compare the results to the untreated ones. Right now, there are two materials that are commonly vapor smoothed. This is ABS or ASA and Polymaker's Polysmooth. These are probably common candidates because their solvents, acetone and isopropyl alcohol, are cheap and relatively safe to handle. Other polymers can be smoothed as well, but for example using chloroform for smoothing PLA requires quite some safety precautions, not even speaking of getting your hands on it. ABS and ASA can be smoothed with acetone. I usually place a container on a heated print bed that is set to around 60 degrees Celsius with some acetone soaked towels in it. The parts are then placed in the container without touching each other. I usually hang them, but you can also just place them on the bottom. The acetone will evaporate and condense on the parts, dissolving the outer layers of the material and in this way smoothing them. Depending on the material and temperature, vapor smoothing can take from a couple of minutes to over an hour. The second material I included in this test is Polymaker's Polysmooth material. Even though it has quite similar printing properties to PLA, it is actually based on another material called PVB or polyvinyl butyrol. This polymer is soluble in rubbing alcohol, which is a bit easier and safer to handle than acetone. You can smooth the parts in a similar fashion to the ABS parts or even just spray them with IPA. The most convenient and even solution is using Polymaker's Polisher, where the solvent is nebulized with an ultrasonic nebulizer and then at the same time rotated evenly in the mist. This method usually takes around 20 to 40 minutes until it's done. By the way, if you find this and my other investigations interesting and helpful, make sure that you're subscribed to the channel and have selected the bell to not miss anything in the future. Since these investigations require a lot of work, my videos are not as regular as those of some other channels. Both smoothing techniques leave the parts very sticky and tacky after the procedure until all of the solvent has evaporated from the material. For normal, visually appealing parts, the surface is back to its normal hardness after a good day or so, but since I wanted to be totally safe and I'm interested in the mechanical properties, I stored all of the parts for 3 weeks until I tested them. For the following tests, I have printed horizontal and vertical test hooks to test firstly if the layer adhesion changes, and secondly, if the smoothing procedure changes the properties of the base part. Half of the parts were smoothed, the other ones were not. For each orientation, material and smoothing status, I had 3 samples for statistical evaluation, which makes 24 samples in total. Before starting the prints, I checked the extrusion amount with my extrusion blocks. This was to make sure that we don't under-extrude, which is detrimental for layer adhesion. All parts were printed with 3 perimeters and 20% infill at a layer height of 0.165 mm. The ABS parts were printed on the enclosed Dremel 3D45 in Spoolworks ABS. The parts somehow showed a slight layer shift right at the bottom, but I still kept them, since that shouldn't influence the tests later. Printing quality in general was okay, only the overhangs didn't look perfect. The polysmooth parts were printed on the original Prusa i3 Mark IIs and came out great except for some stringing. 6 of the 12 ABS parts were then smoothed for a good hour in the acetone vapor on one of my 3D printers. I probably should have removed them a little earlier because the smoothing action still continued a bit after they were removed from the vapor bath. Besides me touching some of the parts while removing, the surfaces looked gorgeous and shiny, but I wasn't able to remove all of the rough parts of the overhanging areas. The polysmooth parts were treated for 40 minutes in the polisher using 99% isopropyl alcohol. These looked very nice and shiny, still keeping a bit of details because I didn't oversmooth them. After 3 weeks of storing and conditioning all of the samples, I tested them on my universal test machine. Let's start with the ABS parts. The horizontal specimens, which were untreated, were able to bear on average 340 newtons of force. They didn't fail abruptly like, for example, PLA tends to do, and strained a lot, still holding at least some load. The vertically printed parts held only 175 newtons, which is just half and shows the lower strength of the 3D printed parts in between the layers. All of them cleanly ripped within the layers, showing their weak point. Now let's take a look at the vapor smooth parts. The horizontal parts failed at an average load of 281 newtons, which is almost 20% less than the unsmoothed counterparts. This is already very interesting. The dimensions of the parts didn't change, so no material was washed away. It seems as if the acetone has permanently damaged the ABS, or even after 3 weeks in normal air, some acetone still remains in the part, decreasing strength. Maybe someone of you knows what's happening there and lets all of us know down in the comments. The next test is probably the most interesting one, which all of you have been waiting for. Is the vertically printed and smooth part stronger? So, did we fuse the layers together and reduce the stress risers? These parts were able to bear 191 newtons of force before failure. This is 10% more than the untreated one, but it seems that this isn't the magical method to improve strength. The interesting part here was that 2 hooks failed at different locations than the other ones. I don't think these were printing problems, and the height of the load was very similar, so I didn't remove them from the statistics. The parts still broke within the layers, and it seems as if the acetone didn't penetrate very deeply. Now let's test the polysmooth material that was smoothed using rubbing alcohol instead of acetone. The horizontal hooks failed on average at 527 newtons, which is quite a bit more than the ABS and in the range of PLA. The parts seem to be way more ductile and didn't shatter like the PLA tends to do. The vertical parts disappointed a little and were only able to bear 188 newtons of load, which is only a good third and reveals more layer adhesion problems. Interestingly, these parts didn't just snap all right between the layers. The IPA smooth horizontal hooks failed on average at 505 newtons, which is a little lower but statistically insignificant, so the smoothing procedure is probably not as detrimental to the material as with ABS and acetone. The vertical parts failed at 183 newtons of load, which is just as good or bad as the unsmoothed version. Also, we can see again that smoothing only really took place at the surface and not very deeply into the parts. Alright, so does vapor smoothing improve the strength of your 3D prints? I think we can clearly say that this is unfortunately not the case. Even though it enhances the look of our parts, there isn't any real positive impact on strength measurable. But what do you think? Do you have any experience? And do you think I could have done something differently or missed out on something? Let me know in the comments and discuss your ideas there.
Thanks for watching, everyone. I hope you have learned something new today. If so, then leave me a like and make sure that you're subscribed and have selected the bell. If you want to support my work and contribute in future videos, then consider becoming a patron or support me in other ways. Also, watch my older videos where I have already tested many other 3D printing problems. I hope to see you guys in the next one. Auf Wiedersehen and goodbye!